Watch out for cockheads like that. Boom! Now you see how close this Subaru is behind you. You must never get in a situation where, look at him, where you get intimidated by people. I'm in a situation here where I can't pull in, so let him past. He's a little bit aggressive, to say the least. He's not going to get anywhere by driving up my arse. And I could soon show him a clean pair of heels, but I don't need to. And it's a good example of why you just got to stay calm and relax. Because at the end of the day, you're in charge of your space on the road. Every vehicle's got different capabilities of going through bends. He's got a four-wheel drive. I've got an enduro bike on enduro tyres, a lot less power. I'm agile and I could do him in a breath because I've been riding a lot of years, but I don't need to worry about him pushing me along. I'll let him do it. At the end of the day, as long as I'm not having to come to a stop with him close behind me, I'm comfortable. And I'll stay comfortable. I won't be intimidated by him. It's one of these situations where you get cockheads and he thinks he owns the road. But trust me, he doesn't. It's all about covering your ass, but he's still up it. The only issue you'd have is when you come into a junction where you've got to stop. And that's when you start slowing down early. You bring your speed down gradually as you're approaching the junction and bring him down, keep him at your speed. Don't leave a bit late braking, because what happens is it could hit you in the ass. You know, and as much as I'm tempted to do him, and I'm sure I bloody could, he couldn't be any closer, could he? But I'm not going to risk it. The thing is, I've got to be careful as well. He's leaning across, as you could see. I don't want to be leaning across the solid white line into oncoming traffic. It's an important little one to remember. Let's just give him a bit of, get out of his way. He's going to get up my arse now, isn't he? I'm trying my best not to. I've just gapped him a little bit, but he'll catch me up again as soon as we come to a corner, because this is what I'm talking about. It's we better stop in the distance, you can see as well. Let's gap him a little bit, and now I've got that junction now that I was talking about, so I'm going to back him up a little bit and slow him down and get him to think. I'm going to indicate left here. Nice early indicator, and just back him up. See, I'm slowing him up here. And you know what? As much as I want to, I'm going to let him go. Go on. WTL930. You know, I mean, it wasn't necessary to ride up my ass. Let him go. And it's just one of these things where you could get a... He's a bully, and look how far it's got him. There's no way is he going to be able to overtake down here without actually doing something really crazy dangerous. There's one overtaking position on this stretch of road all the way down, and I can guarantee he won't get... You see, I'd have been stuck between that Range Rover, and I'd have had that prick up my arse between us all the way down, and now I'm not losing any seconds. And I've got control over him now, more so. And he's right at the arse of that Range Rover. He's not getting anywhere. There's no overtaking down here. There's one stretch, and I can guarantee there'll be a car coming the other way. He won't get the gap. It's now, but he's not even... You see, if he'd been driving properly, you see how he's right up at the arse of that car there? If he'd been back here, he'd have been able to see. But he's too close to it, so he's got no... No way of getting by. He couldn't see it. He poked his nose out into oncoming traffic there without even being able to see. If you drop back, you can see down the inside. You've got all the options from here to get the right gear and blast past everybody at the right moment. But he will not get another opportunity unless he wants to break the law and risk his neck all the way down. And this little XT is lovely. I quite enjoy sending it on a little bit through them bends, but you're caught in danger when you've got an aggressive driver near you. And don't get me wrong, you could grab that with a motorcycle and you get pushed along. It's not worth it if you're a new rider and you don't want to get pushed out of your comfort limit, out of your safety zone. You know, you've got your own limits in relation to your riding skills and experience, and I've got plenty. And my experience paid dividends then. As you saw, I decided I was riding happier at the speed I was, and my experience told me to let him go. And he's still being aggressive, and he's accelerating back and forth. He's probably 8 foot from the back of that car. Here we go, watch. You see, no, he can't get anywhere. And now he's gonna try and go down the inside. Oh, he's on the, you see, he's realised he can't get anywhere. Well, thanks for joining me, you lovely people. I will see you on another one. Watch out for cockheads like that. Boom!